It's time for our people to wake up. Y'all do not know what times we living in right now. We are in the end times. Hey, give me Matthew 24 and 4, read.
Matthew chapter 24, verse 4. And Jesus answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you.
The problem with our people been deceived. Give me 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 4. The Jesus, true Jesus, not this image of this white man here, said, take heed, let no man deceive you. Our people have been deceived by the white image of Jesus Christ. Let's prove that, read.
2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 4. For he that cometh preaching another Jesus.
Let's give you proof and a point, too, that his name Jesus. It said another Jesus. They came and preached another Jesus. Read that again. Because what our people don't understand, Jesus don't even mean nothing but Savior.
Yes, sir.
And this white man right here ain't the Savior. It is what it is. This ain't your Savior. Read that again.
2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 4. For he that cometh preacheth another Jesus.
Who came preaching another Jesus? Who came preaching another Jesus? The so-called white man. Read.
Whom we have not preached.
We didn't preach that. When you go to the book of Daniel's described Jesus as looking like a black man.
That's right.
When you go to the book of Revelations, John described Jesus as looking like a black man, not a damn white man. Read that again.
For if he that cometh preacheth another Jesus, whom we have not preached.
We didn't preach white Jesus. Jesus ain't white. Jesus looked like you.
That's
Jesus
right.
A black man.
Right.
Read.
Or if ye receive another spirit.
Our people received another spirit. What came with white Jesus was homosexuality. What came with white Jesus was child molestation. What came with white Jesus was black on black crime. What came with that white image of the Son of God was sin. Read that again.
For if he that cometh preacheth another Jesus, whom we have not preached, or if ye receive another spirit.
Our people have received the feminine spirit when they came and preached this white image of Jesus right here.
Bring it out.
When they preached this image of the beast. You received the feminine spirit. That's why our men act all soft. That's why our men let the women rule over them. Why? Because this our women God right here.
Right.
This our women God.
Bring it
up. Our women think this they God. Our women think this they say. And you wonder why the black woman don't got respect for the black man. The black woman don't got no respect for the black man because this image right here, your image has been toned down. Give me Leviticus chapter 26. Our people received another spirit and have been taught another Jesus. Time for our people to wake up, repent, and come back to the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High.
That's right.
Read what you got. Leviticus 26, verse 30. Read.
Leviticus chapter 26, verse 30.
This is what happened to the Israelites for breaking God's commandments. Read.
And I will destroy your high places.
The Most High said, I'm going to destroy your high places. A high place is a place of worship. Look at your church. You got a church right here, a church right there. You got churches surrounding this community. But yet, this is the worst community in the city. Read.
And cut down your images.
He said, I'm going to cut down your images. That's why you don't see no images of the prophets being black. That's why you don't see no images of Jesus being black. That's why you see no images of the Israelites being black. God said, I'm going to cut down your images. I'm going to destroy your high places. Read.
And cast your carcasses upon the carcasses of your idols. And my soul shall abhor you.
He said, you're going to die right here in the land of your captivity amongst your idols.
Bring it out.
You're going to die right here in your captivity amongst that Easter bunny that you think that lay eggs. You're going to die right here in your captivity amongst Cupid who's shooting arrows at your ass on Valentine's Day.
Bring it out.
You're going to die right here in front of a damn pumpkin with a damn jack-o'-lantern on Halloween. Right in front of your idols. Tell about people to wake up. God say, I'm going to tear down your images for breaking my commandments. Give me Leviticus 26, verse 14. Matter of fact, go to 19, verse 5. Exodus 19. You know what? Kill it. Matthew 24. Go right back where we were. Let me stay on point. Matthew 24, verse 4. We've been out here almost an hour. Ain't nobody came up and asked a question yet. That's why a lot of y'all gonna die. That's why a lot of y'all gonna die. Men selling crack, crackheads, some people selling crack right in front of us. Women prostituting their body right in front of us. That goes to show you how you give a damn about the word of God. You roll down your window and let your good smoke blow in our face. You turn your rap music up louder when you hear this word coming out. That's why a lot of y'all gonna pine away right here in your iniquity in the land of your captivity. Read.
Matthew chapter 24, verse 4. And Jesus answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you.
You know why he said, take heed, let no man deceive you? Jump down to verse 24. Read.
Verse 24. For thou shalt arise false Christ.
Because he says, don't rise false Christ. That's a false Christ right here. This right here, this a false. This ain't no damn Jesus. This ain't no Savior. And this ain't no Messiah.
Bring it up.
He says, don't rise false Christ. And the false Christ has risen. They came to preach another Jesus, and the disciples warned you about that. Paul warned you that they was going to preach another Jesus. Christ warned you that it was going to rise false Christ. Read that again.
For there shall arise false Christ.
Christ warned you that it was going to rise false Christ. Read.
And false prophets.
And false prophets. Your pastors. Your Christian pastors. Read.
And shall show great signs and wonders.
It said they're going to show great signs and great wonders. Read.
Insomuch that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect.
But they could deceive the very elect. They could deceive the elect. A lot of y'all going to die because you are not of the elect. It is what it is. I'm just going to tell you the truth. You're going to die because you are not of the elect. Time for our people to wake up and repent. You have received another spirit. You have received a false Jesus, a false Christ. That's why our people in the midst of iniquity now. That's why you worship idols. Let me show you how to identify a false prophet. Give me Ezekiel 22, verse 26. We're going to show you how to identify a false prophet. Why can't your Christian pastors won't sit up here and go in the Bible and show you how to identify a false prophet? Show you how to identify somebody that's not sent from God. Our people received a different doctrine, you received a different spirit, and you received a different Jesus. Read what you got.
Ezekiel chapter 22, verse 26. A priest have violated my law.
This is how you identify a false prophet. A false prophet violates the law. The prophets of God always came and told our people, repent and turn to the law.
That's right.
You will not read about one prophet in the Bible that told our people, don't keep God's law.
And
the prophets always testified against the people to get them to turn back to God. Now, the back, let's rule that. Hold that. Give me Nehemiah 9, verse 26. Let's rule that. The prophets always testified against the people to get them to turn back to God, law, statutes, and commandments. It's time for our people to wake up and repent. Read what you got.
Nehemiah chapter 9, verse 26. Nevertheless, they were disobedient and rebelled against thee, and cast thy law behind their backs.
The Most High said, you just like that. You disobedient. You cast the law behind your back. You hear the law come out by pants, you cast it behind your back. You hear the law come out about the Sabbath, you cast it behind your back. You hear the laws come out about marriage, you cast them behind your back. You hear the laws come out about God's dietary law, you cast it behind your back. Read.
And slew thy prophets.
And you hate the prophets. Read.
Which testified against them.
And this is what the prophets did. They testified against you to do what?
To turn them to thee.
To turn you back to the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High. Go back to where you was at. Time for our people to wake up and repent.
That's right.
The prophets always testified against you to turn you back to the Most High God.
Right.
To get to repent. That's what repent means, turn back.
That's right.
What do you need to turn back to? You need to turn back to God's laws.
That's right.
That's why we're in captivity now. That's why you dying in the streets every day. That's why the STD rate high in your community. That's why you women can't get married. Why? Because you don't keep the laws about fornication. You don't keep the laws on, the reason why you women can't get married because you don't keep the laws of marriage. You don't know how to dress. You don't keep the laws that teaches you to dress modestly.
Bring it up.
Read what you got.
Ezekiel chapter 22, verse 26. Her priests have violated my law.
So a true prophet gonna teach you to keep the laws. They always came and testified against you to turn you back to God's laws. So how do you identify a false prophet? How do you identify a false priest, a false servant of God? They're going to turn their eyes away from God's law, read.
And have profaned my holy things.
They profane the holy things. They don't keep God's high holy days. They don't keep God's Sabbaths. Read on.
They have put no difference between the holy and profane.
A false prophet won't put no difference between the holy and profane. The law is holy. You Israelites supposed to be holy to the Most High God.
That's right.
They put no difference between the holy and profane. A homosexual is profane. A man that lay down with another man, that's profane. A woman that lay down with another woman is profane. But your priests, your false prophets, they put no difference between the holy and profane. They put no difference between the holy and profane. Read.
Neither have they showed difference between the unclean and the clean.
This is how you identify a false prophet. A false prophet will not show difference between what's clean and what's unclean.
Right.
It's in the Bible.
Bring it up.
Every prophet that came and walked the earth always testified against our people to turn them back to God's laws, to get them to repent, to teach our people to be holy.
Right.
You ain't learning how to be holy in the church. Read on. He said a false prophet, they make no difference between the holy and profane. They violate God's laws. They make no difference between what's clean and what's unclean. Read.
And have hid their eyes from my Sabbath.
This is another sign of a false prophet. A false prophet won't keep the Sabbath. The Most High gave us straight commandments on what to do on the Sabbath.
That's right.
God said no buying and selling on the Sabbath. No working on the Sabbath. No cooking on his Sabbath day. And God said, come together in a holy convocation and a holy gathering. Your priest hid his eyes from the Sabbath. Saturday is the Sabbath day. They keep it on Sunday. This is how you know the difference between a true prophet and a false prophet. The false prophet will not keep God's Sabbath days. How the hell you have a fish fry on God's Sabbath day with unclean food?
Bring it out.
You got a catfish fry. Catfish is unclean. A false prophet make no difference between the clean and unclean. They got pork chops and chitlins cooking on the Sabbath day.
Here you
go. A false prophet make no difference between the clean and unclean. He violate God's laws and he don't keep the Sabbaths. We showing y'all right now what a false prophet is. Matter of fact, read on.
Verse 27. Her princes in the midst thereof are like wolves raving the prey, to shed blood and to destroy souls.
The false prophets destroy souls. They ain't get you to repent. They'll not teach you about the laws of marriage. They'll not teach you about the dietary laws. They'll not teach you about the moral laws, the ceremonial laws, or the civil laws that God got set up.
You know,
God gave us these laws to give us a kingdom. God, you can't rule no kingdom without a law.
Right.
You can't rule a kingdom without a law.
Read
but God wanted us to rule our kingdom righteously.
That's right.
Read on.
To shed blood and to destroy souls, to get dishonest gain.
To get dishonest gain. How do a priest or a false priest or a false prophet get dishonest gain? They tell you that God's laws are done away with, but yet at the same time, let's keep the law tight. Give me your 10%. That's dishonest gain right there. Because the law of tithing is done away with. You can't tithe no more. The tithing was for the priest. The tithing was for the priest. Why? Because they didn't get their own portion of land when God divided the land among the Israelites. Every tribe got a piece of land except the Levites. The Levites was to take in 10%. He was to take in 10% from his brethren, the children of Israel. And once the Levites take in 10%, they was to give another 10% to the high priest. So it ain't no high priest on earth now. Why? Because Christ became the high priest.
That's right.
Christ is a high priest. So how will you get high as your priest gonna give 10% of the tithes to Christ?
Right.
And he ain't even not a Levite. That's dishonest gain right there.
Bring it out.
Tell foul people to wake up and repent. Read.
And her prophets have duped them with untempered water.
You hear that? The Most High said, y'all have been duped. Y'all hasn't been duped. You have been duped by your slave master. Hey, give me Isaiah 58 real quick. Isaiah 58. Matter of fact, give me Isaiah 56. What the last couple of verses. Terrify people to wake up. We just sold you out to identify a false prophet. A false prophet don't keep God's Sabbath. The Sabbath day is certain day. The false prophet gonna tell you God's law is done away with when every prophet before time have always testified against you to turn you to God's laws. A false prophet make no difference between the unclean and the clean. He'll tell you, look, hey, he'll tell you that, hey, it's your God-given right to be a homosexual. That's unclean. That's nasty. That's defiled. That's profane. He makes no difference between the holy and profane. That's what a false prophet does. Read what you got. Isaiah 58, verse 10.
Isaiah chapter 56, verse 10. His watchmen are blind.
A false prophet is blind. They don't see what's going on right now. Every time we step out here on the streets and bring the word out, our people don't see. The pastors don't see. We have went in some of these pastor churches and brought them the word out, and they still blind to what God is doing on the planet Earth right now.
Right.
Read out. They can't see the words in this Bible. They can't see the truth. We still dealing with your false prophets, your false preachers, your false pastors.
Right.
That make no difference between the clean and unclean, the holy and profane, that don't keep God's Sabbath and they violate the law. Read.
They are all ignorant.
God said your pastor's ignorant as hell. Your pastor's ignorant. Matter of fact, what does he call?
They are all dumb dogs.
God said your damn pastors is dumb dogs. Ask your pastor to break down Revelation 13. Ask your pastor what's the color of Christ. Ask your pastor when is the Sabbath day. God said they ignorant and they dumb dogs. And they blind, read.
They cannot bark.
He said they can't bark. They can't come out here and prophesy like we do. We rolled up on the pastor last week, 2 weeks ago. We broke the Bible out. He fled. They can't bark. They can't prophesy. They can't warn you. And they won't warn you from the destruction. That's what a dog do. A watchman, a watchdog barks.
That's
he warns you that destruction is coming.
Right.
Your pastors ain't out here. They ain't telling you what's coming. That's why a lot of y'all is going to die on these three cones. A lot of y'all going to die commit fornication. A lot of y'all going to die in the midst of adultery. A lot of y'all going to die with an STD. They can't bark. They won't warn you. Read.
Sleeping. Lying down. Loving to slumber.
They loving to slumber. They sleep. They love to slumber. Read on.
Yay. They are greedy dogs.
He said they greedy dogs. They don't want nothing but your money. Your pastors don't want a damn thing but your money. That's why Creflo Dollar just said, Creflo Dollar said, hey, he wish he can line the non-titles up and everybody grab a Uzi and they shoot the non-titles.
Hey,
God said your pastors is what?
Greedy dog.
God called your pastors a greedy dog. Creflo Dollar, greedy dog. Joy Osteen, a greedy dog. What's the name of that lady down the street? Down the hill south, she a damn greedy dog.
Which can never have enough.
Which can never have enough. They rob the people. They taking your money. They are not putting anything back into the communities. When you laid on your when you about to get put out your house, you can't go to your pastor and tell, hey, I'm about to get put out my house. Help me, pastor. The only people that can get church help in the church is the women. The women that's sleeping with the pastor. That's it. The women that's sleeping in the pastor that's going to drop them drawers, that's going to hit them knees. They're the only ones that can get help in your churches. And some of your these women pastors gay. Yep. They got a masculine spirit on them. Because only a man is set up to lead a congregation,
that's
not
right.
A woman according to God.
Right.
A woman can't lead a congregation and a woman can't lead men. Proving the point that you women can't lead men, look at your badass kids on the news every day. Can't do it by yourself, neither. And I'm gonna tell y'all, I can't understand this Bible. You leaders that can't understand why we in the conditions we in, you will not wake up. That's why God said you love to sleep. They love to slumber. Your pastors love to stay sleeping in this captivity. Because they just want your money.
Bring it out.
Okay, I ain't gonna hear nothing the Rizzo like saying, but I do want this 10%. Ring.
Everyone for his gain from his quarter. Come yea, say they. I will fetch wine, and we will fill ourselves with strong drink. And tomorrow shall be as this day, as much more abundant.
That's what they say. Hey, let's go get us some wine. Let's fill ourselves with some strong drink. And the next day, hey, it's going to be better. Every time they take your money, every time you come up in their church and you give your 10%, they celebrate. They popping bottles, the best wine. This is what the scriptures say. Go back to Matthew 24:4. Tell five people to wake up, repent, come back to the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High. You are the Israelites the Bible speaks of.
That's right.
The Most High said, your watchmen are dumb dogs. They ignorant, they blind, and they will not bark. They will not warn you about the destruction that's coming to this place. Read.
Matthew 24:4. And Jesus answered and said unto them, take heed. Let no man deceive you.
God said, take heed, let no man deceive you. Our people have been deceived. You have been deceived. They came and preached another Jesus. Read.
Saying, for shall come in my name.
He said, for many shall come in my name. Read.
Saying, I am Christ.
He said, many going to come in my name saying, I am Christ. Many came in the name of Jesus. Christ, first of all, Christ warned you.
Yes.
Then Paul said, hey, he that come and preach another Jesus, and you receive another spirit, it happened. This Bible is a true book. It happened. Jesus don't look like no white man. Jesus don't look like Marilyn Manson. Jesus don't look like John Lennon. Jesus don't look like no white man, man.
Bring it out.
Read.
And shall deceive many.
He said, many gonna come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and deceive many. That's why your little kids think a white man is God.
Bring it out.
Your kids think white man is God. Black man, you supposed to have a problem with that.
Right.
You supposed to have a problem with your child thinking white man is God. You supposed to have a problem with your wife, with your black woman thinking a white man is God. For real though, you supposed to have a problem thinking that with your wife thinking that the white man coming back to save her. Supposed to have a problem with that. But y'all don't give a damn though. That's why a lot of y'all gonna die right here in the land of your captivity. A lot of y'all gonna die right here on South Parkway in Bellevue. You'll get killed right here when the nuclear destruction comes. Because you hate God, you hate the Bible, and you hate yourself. And you hate your own people. Look at that, somebody just cut a flip right there. Read on.
And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of
wars. He said you should hear of wars and rumors of wars. You hear of wars, right? It's not you hearing of wars and rumors of wars. They preached another Jesus to you. Many came in his name saying, I am Christian. Trying to use this word to deceive our people. Now, are not you hearing of wars and rumors of wars? Read.
See that ye be not troubled.
He said, see that ye be not troubled, read.
For all these things must come to pass.
He said, all these things must come to pass. You're going to hear about wars. You're going to hear about wars. It's going to be wars. It's going to be rumors of wars. Read.
But the end is not yet.
But we getting close. It ain't yet, but we getting close. We know we close now because the Israelites are waking up.
That's right.
We all over on your street corners. Read.
For nation shall rise against nation.
You see that nation is rising against nation. You see Pakistan rise against Israel. You see Russia rising against Afghanistan. You see China versus Russia or whatever the hell. You see the wars that's going on. Read.
And kingdom against kingdom. And there shall be famines. And pestilence.
You see the famines. What about Flint, Michigan? Flint, Michigan just didn't have no water. Pestilences, them diseases. What about the Zika virus? What's the name of that other virus they just had? You just had the Zika virus. You had the swine flu. You got the Ebola. You heard about pestilences. Read.
And earthquakes.
They just had a big ass earthquake in Japan again. 7.5 magnitude. 6.9 magnitude.
9.0 magnitude. Read. And earthquakes in diverse places.
In different places. All over the earth, earthquake. You sitting on a fault line right now. Memphis gonna get it. I know Memphis gonna get it.
Tennessee is gonna get it, read. And these are the beginning of sorrows.
He said this is the beginning of sorrows. A lot of y'all gonna die. You gonna die, why? Because you are an Israelite, you are God's chosen people, and you not will not repent and keep the commandments of God.
Bring it out.
Time for our people to wake up.
I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC. To stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.